Hello everyone and welcome back. In this video, we'll see one more case study related to finance department. How do I clean this kind of financial data when I get from the company? It becomes very tedious and very challenging part to create a pivot table or to do any analysis part, or if I want to create a chart, report, anything. So you see on the screen, I have some data that's a financial data, and you see I have June, July, the cells are merged. Then I have the second heading, actual budget and the variance, same way actual budget and variance. On the left hand side, if you see, there's a revenue given and these are the empty rows. Total revenue is given, expenses, total empty rows. And same way at the bottom, there are two empty rows or one single null row at the bottom, the blank rows. How do I clean this data and convert into this format? So I can create a chart, pivot table, pivot report, anything with the help of this data. So from coming this data, you know, unclean data to clean data, it takes only 7 to 8 button clicks in Power Query. 7-8 button clicks, no using function, no using any formula, no anything. Just using few button clicks in Power Query, we'll see how to clean this data. Now, before going to Power Query, let me explain you what are the things we'll be doing here. First thing, I'll try to fill down this column so that I can get revenue everywhere. Same way, I'll get expenses on all the places. Second thing, I don't want this total revenue, total expenses, net loss and income, because this total values I can calculate later on. So I'll try to filter this values here. Third thing, if you see, there are two column headings into this data here. I cannot unpivot two column headings. In the previous video, if you've seen the case study, there was only one column heading Jan to December. It was easy to unpivot, but there are two column headings you cannot unpivot. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to merge these two records and then you have to unpivot. Okay, that's the thing. But again, there's a challenge. There is no merging rows in Power Query. There's merging columns possible in Power Query. So I have to do a transpose, merge the columns, etc., etc., and etc. And finally, I'll come back to that clean data. So start with the basic one. Let me show you how to pull this data and do it further. So right now what I've done is I have created a name range and given the data as my data, the name range as my data. I have purposely selected this data here. I cannot convert this into a table and get it because it doesn't look like a table format. Okay. Now, after giving this name range, click on data tab and click on from table. So ignore the warning which you're getting. Right. Now you can see I have got the data that is column 1, column 2 and so on. And carefully observe, when I had June, there were 3 cells which were merged. Now you see June, null, null, July, null, null. These are the values given. So I have to also fill right. There is no fill right option in Power Query. There's only fill down or fill up. So that thing also I have to work out. So first thing, select the column 1, transform, and I'll just select the option fill down. So if I click on fill down, you can see all the places, revenue, total revenues, expenses will come here. Now I have to remove this total revenues and also total expense and net income loss. So click on this drop down. And I can select the option from here as deselect total revenue, expense and net income loss, because this can be calculated later on. So in normal table, you don't need this aggregation value. So click on OK. That has been removed. Next thing, if I want to fill on the right, there is no method. OK, June fill right, July fill right. You see, there is no fill right or fill left option. So I have to transpose the table. So then only I can fill down that option. OK, so now I'll just click on this transform tab, transpose, and you can see this has been transposed. Now it becomes very easy to fill down. So select the column and now I can select the option as fill down. Okay, I've got this data here. After filling down, when I again transpose back, because I brought it for filling down, this will be two column headings. There is no method in Power Query to unpivot two column headings. There's only one method. You can only combine these columns and make it as one column. So select those two columns. So I'll select these two columns, that is column 1 and column 2, and I'll try to merge these columns using transform, and there's an option given as merge columns, and the separator can be anything, comma, space, anything, because later on I'll just remove that delimiter. So I'll select the option as colon and I'll click on OK. Now these two columns have become one. Okay, these two columns have become one. Now why did I combine these columns? You can see right now, again, if I click on transpose, now I have only one column heading. Previously, I had two column headings. Now I have only one column heading. Now, the last thing, if I want to unpivot, I have to promote this as headers. This row should be promoted as headers. So transform, and you can see there are two options. Use first row as headers. So I'll select the option as use first row as headers. Now you can see all the headers have been given here, June, June budget, variance, and so on. Now, the last thing is, I have to keep these two columns constant, and I can unpivot the other columns, because you see, this is June, 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 and so on. So select those two columns, right click on any column heading, any selected column heading, and then you can select the option as unpivot other columns. Click on unpivot other columns, and you can see the data is coming into a table format. It has still not come. We have to again clean the data. This attribute column has to be separated. The separator here is nothing but colon. So transform tab, and I have the option as split column, split by delimiter. So I'll select split by delimiter, and automatically it will pick up the delimiter, that is colon. I have to click on OK, and you can see these are two different columns I have. After doing that, what I can do is I can just keep on renaming the columns here. So I'll just double click here and type as month. Second one I'll write as details, or actual hyphen I can write as budget. And third one I can just write as product type. And fourth one I can write as revenue or expense. Okay, revenue and expense, please ignore the spelling. Yeah, so I've got this four columns, and I think this variance can be calculated later on. So I can just click on this drop down, and I can select the option, deselect this variance, click on OK. Okay, so this is a clean data which can be used for creating charts, reports, and visualization, anything. Now I can click on home, close, and load. Okay, so see, that's a new data which I've got. And this is the unclean data which cannot be used for analysis purpose. Any point of time you want to go back and see what are the steps I've applied. So what you can do is you can just double click here, that is my data. And now you'll get this Power Query Editor. What was the first step, second step, third step? This is the revision. So you can just click on the first step. This first two steps automatically come. Third step is, if you see, that is a fill down. Okay, so you see that's a fill down. Keep on observing. If I keep on clicking here, the steps would be given here. So the filtered rows, and then I transpose the table, and then I fill down, and then I merge the columns and transpose, etc., etc. So this can be notes for you. You can keep these notes with you. At any point of time, if you get similar case study, you can apply the steps. Yes, depending upon the logic which is relevant to your example. So I can just click on close, and that's it. So any changes made in this data will be reflected into your output data. And same if you create a pivot table or any pivot chart from this data, same story, data source changes and the values will change here. So I hope you have understood how to clean this financial data by using Power Query in just few button clicks. That's all for this video.